let's get right into it and talk a little bit about what today's topic and why we are all here. Why we are here is because we want to understand how to trade today's volatile markets. So you've seen what's happened with the coronavirus. See what's happening now, people working from home. You see what's happening that, you know, the market taking off, going from 18,000. Now we're back up to 27,000 in less than 3 months. Now we're getting into what's the earnings season. How do we trade these stocks at earnings season? How do we know what's going up or going down? That's what we're looking to do today. So what I'm about to do is I'm going to show everybody, I'm going to talk about trading and what the style of CyberTrading University and what we do and, you know, why we're trading today's markets. And then hopefully at the end of this presentation, everybody's going to get a very clear understanding of how little we knew about trading and how we could profit and benefit from today's markets. And that's what we're going to focus on. But before we do that, I just want to tell you a little about CyberTrading University. By the way, before I do that, could everyone just tell me, how many times have you been here before? Is this the first time you watch CyberTrading University? Is the second, the fifth, the 10th, the one? Just want to find out and get to know a little bit about everyone. Third time, Charles, you second. Steve, we got a first timer here. First, okay. Scott says several times, lots of times, a CTU student. Good to see you, Wayne. Many times. All right, first time, first timers. All right, good, good. We have a lot of many. And you know, it's lots of times, John. Good, good. Student, perfect. All right, so the thing is this. We have a lot of students here, and they love coming back for some of you here the first time because we're looking to recruit people that we could teach how to trade so we could trade with you. You see, trading is a team. It's not, you know, a one-man show. You can't just go out there and do it on your own. So everybody's here because they want to see the feedback. They want to see what people are saying. And you know what? We always learn something new, and that's what it's about. But how did I become very good at it? Well, I don't know if you read any of the old books, but I'm one of the original SOS bandits. SOS stands for Small Order Execution System. If you read any of the old books, I was actually, when I started, it was about 500 to 1,000 traders. Now there are several hundred people that day trade every day. So I know some of you are probably older than me, maybe younger than me, but I'm probably your grandfather in this business. So I'm one of the very few that is still around for so long. I never forget, I bumped into Kramer from CNBC and he's like, I can't believe you're still in the game. I'm like, oh, why should I not be? You know, if you know what you're doing, you know, after going through the internet bubble, the financial crisis, the flash crash, now we're dealing with the coronavirus. I mean, it's just, there's no better business to be in than in day trading. And let me tell you what I learned. I was actually you 25 years ago. If you read my book, How to Beat Market Makers in Their Own Game, you know, I was a big failure rate. And you know why I failed? For one main reason, ignorance. You know, I mean, a lot of you are a lot probably older than in 22, but back then, I mean, like, what do I need to learn, right? Everybody's like, ah, I'll go try it myself. I'll do it my own. But you know what the biggest problem that you people don't realize? No, everybody likes to talk about the winners. Nobody talks about the losers. Nobody talks about the losers. And you know what? The losers are what destroy us. That's what we get killed on. And I never understood how the market actually worked. And even though I had a little bit of sense of some of you, like you two, might feel the same, it's not about that. It's about knowing where the big boys are. And that's what we have to understand. And I did not know that until I took a job as a trader. So I want to pass over that knowledge, what I basically learned, over to you, because I know a lot of you here want to do this. And I hate to tell you this, it's not for everybody, but there's only one way to find out, is to come in and join my trading room. At the end of this presentation, I'm going to invite every single one of you to come and see and learn and chat back to the traders that we trained to come into that floor of that exchange, the oldest, most popular trading room in the industry, and get that opportunity to see what in the hell is everybody ramping and raving about. But to do that, I don't want to waste your time. Let me go over for the next hour. Let me tell you a little bit about stocks that were good in earnings, why they're going up, how do we know they're going to go down, who's running them up, how do we prepare for it, you know, and is this something that you want to make a career out of it? So that's realistically how I got started and how I want to pass over to you. So I know a lot of you basically got started too. I see we have a lot of new first timers here. And it's probably not going to be the last time you're going to see me too. You know, it's funny. I just had a student the other day come up to me. He goes, you know, Fausto, I've been watching you since 2016. I'm finally ready to hit the button. But I've been taking and been watching people over and over. And you know what they keep telling me? Your name keeps coming up. And I'm like, and I know, and now I know why. You're endorsed by the biggest brokerage firms in the industry. You know, listen, we're not the greatest marketers. You're not going to find us going to advertise on, you know, on TV and on YouTube and everything else. We don't have to, okay? Be honest with you, we really don't need anybody's business here. Only business I need is I need people I could train that can make money with. And so if you think you have it in you, let's see what I'm about to show you and see if you do have it. So I'm looking for people to join my family. That's what I'm looking for, because trading is a team and it's a family. And that's what you have to look at it. So have you guys been following the latest earnings reports? Okay. So everybody wants to know, where do you get your news from? And, you know, how do you know how to trade these earnings reports? Because let me tell you something. Dell Computers is fighting to stay in business every 90 days. Okay, actually 128 days. Every quarter, every 3 months, this company is fighting to stay in business before it goes out of business. So as long as they've been in business for as long as it is, they have to beat earnings. Now, is it good earnings? Is it bad earnings? Is it help out? You're seeing a lot of stocks coming out with earnings right now. You see what's happening with a lot of these airline stocks, these cruise stocks. You know, what is actually going to plan on happening? Well, honestly, I'm not an earnings guy. I know how to read them. I know how it works. I know how, you know, revenue versus earnings, PE ratio works, book value works. But the thing is this, how many times have you seen stock beat earnings and the stock ends up going down? How many times you see stocks didn't come out with good earnings and the thing took off? It's not about, you know, you analyzing the earnings. It's about you knowing that a company is going to come out with news and it's going to be very active. Because why are you really here? You're here for one reason and one reason only, and that is to make money. That's it. Because when you look at this calendar right here, right? What's today? Today's the 22nd. There are 162 companies coming out with earnings. Who the hell is going to be able to watch all of them? 157 today, 43 tomorrow, next week, 206, 290, 267, 336. Look at all these earnings are coming out. This is going to be the foundation of where the market's going. This right now, ladies and gentlemen, is going to justify what is going on with the coronavirus. And guess what? You are in a no better place right now than to know how to trade them and knowing how you could profit from it. Because if it's good, you go long. If it's bad, you go short. That's basically what comes down to it. But which is the best one to trade? Everyone always asks. Well, any one of these stocks that we trade will come up in something called the big percentage gainers and losers. Okay. You can't trade every single one of them. What we're looking to do is trade stocks that have action in it. That's really what it comes down to it. We need stocks that have good volatility, good action. Because I don't know what EROS up 104%, you know, 24 million shares, you know, SGRY, AKRX, you know, Gene, well, TX and the TRNX was pretty good. The MIST was awesome today. But how do you find these stocks? You have to see if they show up in the big percentage gainers. Just because a company comes out of earnings, the stock will probably won't, you know, I would say 95% of them won't do anything. Now, let's get right back to the live broadcast. So every morning I go out there and we do a live audio broadcast at 9 o'clock in the morning. Okay. We start trading at 8 o'clock in the morning. So, you know, a lot of stocks come out with earnings in pre-market, and it's amazing. Some people still realize like, oh, I wish I could trade that stock in the morning. Well, guess what? You'll be able to watch us and how we do it in a trading room. But I would say that almost half my trades are done in pre-market. Half my students' trades are done in pre-market. Why? Because we have all these orders coming in from people like you that don't have access to it, which following the market maker and we're trading it. So, and then some of you are like, oh, I want to trade this stock. Well, guess what? You can do it, but you got to have the right tools. So let's go back and talk about the CCL. Okay. So you see CCL stock goes from 1450, shoots up to 1550, up to $16, right? What is the strong levels? What is your risk? Why did it go up? Who backed it off? Why is there profit taking? Where's the next resistance levels? Well, that's what I want to talk about right now. Because the most important thing of you being a very successful trader is you have to follow the money. Once you think you know something about the stock market, you're going to lose. That's what I was always taught from my mentors. So let's be the guys like on the left, not the guy average Joe on the right. So what you're about to see right now, fellow traders, is going to be very disturbing. And I say that all the time to people. Like, what's disturbing? Because you're going to realize that what you're about to learn and about to see is like, you know what? How in the hell could I even compete without knowing this data? You're also going to be very angry at yourself because you're going to be like, how did you not know this stuff? And then maybe some of you would be more disappointed. You'd be like, you know what? I spent all this money on training. How did they not know this stuff and didn't tell me about it? And I'm only going to tell you one thing. First of all, you always have to ask yourself, who really trained you? Who endorses them? Had they been on NASDAQ? Had they been on TradeStation? Had they been on Thinkorswim? Had they been on Schwab? You don't think these brokerage firms do credit checks and background checks on CyberTrade University? They would never let us do a presentation if they thought we were teaching people how to lose money. But what they want you to know is they want you to have a fighting chance. And this is the fighting chance. I'm going to start off with one very popular platform that I do a lot of events for on NASDAQ. It's about NASDAQ Total View. Now, a question to everybody here. I like to call it level three. So I'm going to do a quick poll question here. And I'm just going to curious, just want to see if you guys have it. So I'm going to launch this poll. So can everyone just tell me, do you guys have level three or total view, whatever it is? Just give me a yes or no. By the way, if you're a student, please don't answer this question. Okay. And I'm going to share this with everybody. That's okay, Dennis. You have the poll that popping up on your end. I just give it another couple of more seconds. It's a yes or no question. It's pretty simple. I mean, if you're not sure, I'll take that as a no too. All right, so let me end the poll and let me share it. So you could see right here, there's a lot of you out there that don't have it, and which is okay. That's what we're here to learn. So let me explain to you what it is, why this is the foundation, not even the house, the building of the house. This is the foundation of trading. NASDAQ Book Viewer is going to show you over 20 to 50 times more data than any level two platform or any level one price. This is going to show you every single order that's out there of people that are trading on the floor of the NASDAQ market, which there's really no floor. It's their electronic system. Everyone out there that's placing orders out there around the world. So we're looking at Uber, and let me just get my crayon here so you guys can follow along so you can see my little dot. So here are your buy orders and here are your sell orders. Okay. So basically you see all the buyers and you see all the sellers is what you're seeing. And you're seeing them at what price and how many shares they want to buy and how many different orders are out there, meaning how many people around the world make up that 200, 1400, 2000 share order. Okay. So right here, you're seeing everything. Now they call the NASDAQ market a negotiated market. It's basically a big chat room. So what does that mean is that people are negotiating what they want to buy for and what they want to sell it for. So you get to see the real orders out there. Okay. So how do we utilize this data? Well, I assume everyone here knows how to read a chart. Okay. I'm going to keep it very simple. No indicators, no lines, no nothing. On a chart, basically what it's saying is what the stock did in the past. Okay. So just make sure you guys can hear me okay. So it's what you've seen and what's happening in the past. So you see what the buyers are doing, and you can see here on the chart how the stock went down, kind of stopped right here. You notice how it stopped right there, right around the $13 price, and then it shot right back up and went to $13.80. Now that's a pretty substantial move in a matter of 2 hours. 13 to 13.80, 1,000 shares, $800, $200,000 salary. Who doesn't want that job? But the question is, why did it stop at 13? Why didn't it go to 10? Why didn't it stop at 14? Why 13? Well, when you look at NASDAQ Book Viewer, you'll notice that between 13.01 and $13, you're talking there is literally 130,000 shares looking to be bought at that price. Not 300, not 700, 130,000. And you're talking close to over 150 different orders out there that make up between 13.01 and $13. So think about it. Why else would the stock go up? Because somebody said it on CNBC and some analyst came out there? No, some, you know, whatever it could be, you know, they signed a contract. What? No, it has nothing to do with it. There's someone out there, and it's not someone, it's 150 someones, okay, that want to buy the stock at $13. So at the end of the day, what is that called? That's called a support level. That's basically what we call that. Now, same thing goes for resistance levels. Look at this stock, American Airlines. Look, it went from 32 at 9:30 this morning and shot went all the way up to $34. Stock went up $2. After 10:30, the stock comes right back down from 34, right back down to $33. Why did it go down? Very simple. It must be a resistance levels. Now, it's not what's predicated what happened in the past. What's predicated is what's going on in the future. And the future tells me that there is a, and I'll circle it here so you guys can see it black and white. At 34, there's a 123,000 share seller at $34. And there's 39 different people out there around this world that make up that, you know, that 123,000 shares. No wonder the stock went ahead of resistance levels here and went back down. Not because some lagging indicator said so. It's because of that big order out there. That is what makes stocks go up and go down. Supply and demand. Buyers and sellers. By the way, is anybody confused? Did I lose anybody yet? Just give me a yes or no. Adam, we're going to get to that question. Okay, we're going to get to that question. Joe, you good? Kathy, you good? Okay, anyone else? Listen, we got over 100, 200 people in this room. Guys, don't be shy. Don't be embarrassed. Do you guys, are you following along? Because I just want to make sure that I'm not talking to somebody that's just walked away and is not here. Listen, one of the rules for you to qualify to be part of my trading room is you got to pay attention. If you can't pay attention, I would rather not train you because you're going to probably lose all your money. And I'm just being honest with you. Trading is not like, you know, you're sitting there and, you know, people shooting shots and whatever it is. If you're going to do that, then you're definitely better off waiting for the government to open up the offices and go back to work. But if you want to learn how to trade, you got to be very focused on. This is the greatest job in the world. It's one of the most prestigious jobs in the world. You know, so why not go out there and learn how to do it the right way? Donnie says it's awesome. Thank you very much, Donnie. I appreciate it. Silic says, how do we get NASDAQ told of you? We didn't get there yet. I'm not here to sell you anything. I'm not here to tell you to buy this and sell that. I don't work for any of these brokerage firms. I don't work for the exchange. I don't work for anybody. Okay. You know who I work for? You. You and I are going to work together and we're going to use these platforms to make money to trade today's markets. But you have to be convinced first if this is something that you get. You understand? Joanne, yes. This is basically order flow. We're following the orders. I'm a tape reader. That's basically what I am. So what I'm telling you is basically, this is what exactly what you just asked is exactly what you're looking at. Just out of curiosity, did you know that at all? Did anybody know that? That this is basically what we call tape reading? Well, the tape reading part didn't get here till time and sales. A little bit, Joan? Okay, good. Now, the thing is this. A lot of people make charting more complicated than what it is. Let me just clear this out. But it's not really not. Now, let's look at this example over here. Let's look at American Airlines. So let me start a new poll, okay? So my question is this. Okay, is this stock going up or going down? Look at the chart and answer the poll question. It's not a complicated question. Now, if you get this question wrong, you definitely got to quit trading. You really got to quit trading. All right. So, by the way, if you're not answering this question, then you definitely should quit trading. Okay. If you answered it and you're wrong, you're 50% there. If you don't answer this question and don't know how, you should definitely quit trading. Okay. All right. So, end poll, share results. So you could see right here that 97% of you said it's going down. I have no idea where you, the 3% of the people here think it's going up. I don't know. I don't see it. I don't get it. But if you said it was going down, congratulations. You are absolutely correct. Okay. Now, don't worry about if you said it was going up, because that's why we're here. We're here to learn, right? So now the next question is this. Here's a $64,000 question. What is going to make this stock go up? I mean, we know that American Airlines not going straight to zero. I mean, that could happen. It happened to Nortel, for some of my Frank Canadian friends. Someone ever thought that. And MCI, remember that stock? You know, the list goes on and on. But when will the stock go up? We need buyers. We need demand, right, Bob Allen, right? We need buyers, okay? So do you see buyers on a chart? No. What do we need? We need level three. So now when I look at level three, you'll notice that as I'm working down, we're looking for something called, what we call here at Cybertrading University, an iceberg order. An iceberg order is a big block order, okay? And right down here at the bottom, you could see that there are 334 orders around the world on the NASDAQ exchange that want to buy the stock at $11.50. And not only that, but there's another 131,000, just literally a penny below that. You're talking over 260,000 shares looking to be bought at $11.50. So in theory, what do you think is going to happen when we get to that price, $11.50, everyone? What do you think is going to happen? Is it going to go up or is it going to go down? It's probably going to go up without looking at anything else. And by the way, yes, those are real orders, okay? Guess what? Now we're looking at what happened in the future. You'll notice that American Airlines went from right where that big buyer was at 11.50, and it went right up to 12.20 in a matter of about 2 hours. If you bought 1,000 shares out there and you bought it right where that support level is and you sold it right now, guess what? You make about 80 cents on 1,000 shares. It's literally, what, $11,500 investment. You made yourself close to $2. I'll take it. Where are you gonna make that? Even if you made a buck on that trade, it's $250,000 salary. Who's paying $250,000 salaries today with the coronavirus going on? You know who's paying for it? Trading the market. Okay, a couple of questions coming across here. Now, I can't answer all these questions. I'm going to save them for the end because I only have about 20 minutes left. So for some of you, we have staff here that's going to answer people's questions as we go along. So, you know, but a lot of your questions and some of you come up is going to be answered as we move forward. All right. I just don't want to lose where we left off. I could sit here and talk to everyone all day. All right. So looking at the stock right here, where's resistance levels on SRNE? Can anybody tell me where would you think resistance levels would be? $6.98, $7, or $7.02? Joan, yes, we start at 8 o'clock in the morning, Eastern time. Where do you think resistance levels is on this stock? You know what? It's almost like a dumb question. And you know why I'm asking this dumb question? The reason why I'm asking this dumb question is because how many of you out there are monitoring the sellers of 440,000 shares out there at $7? How many of you here actually see that? Not that many. Not that many. You know, I always like to say this. Do you ever go out there and feel like whenever you buy a stock, it goes down? And then every time you sell it, as soon as you sell it, the thing goes up. And sometimes you feel that some people are watching you. It's like, you know what? They're watching me. You know, I can't do anything right. Has it ever happened to anybody? Mick, it's happened to you? Kathy says it happens. That's me laughing out loud. You thought it was an indicator, Joe? All right. Well, you know what? Can I be honest with you? It's not that they can't watch you. It's not that they're watching you. The problem is you're not watching them. You understand? You are now seeing the hardcore data about them out there that are selling it. How many of you are actually looking at where those orders are? You know, I mean, you go out there using all these indicators, use all these platforms, you read all these books, you're watching all these YouTube videos, you get spammed from, you know, these commercials on YouTube because it's listening to you. Hey, you want to learn how to trade? Hey, I made $30,000 today. You want to make it? Yeah. First of all, when you see people like that, do yourself a favor. Block them out. You know, not that they're bad people, but I just look at it like, you know what? For you to make $30,000, you got to be willing to risk to lose $30,000. How many of you guys here could afford to make, you know, would like to make $5,000 a day? I would too, but you know what? You got to be willing to afford to lose $10,000 tomorrow. You know? You know what? You don't have to make a lot of money to make a successful career at this. I mean, it all sounds good with the, you know, all that sexiness of driving nice cars and this and that. I don't know. I'm more of a realist. You know, here at Cybertrain University, we're not show offs. No one's allowed to show off. Nobody brags how much money they make. We only talk about points, but we do talk about. It's the ones that are quiet, the ones you got to worry about. Because those are the ones that obviously do well. You don't have to go out there and brag. It only gets you in trouble, I'll be honest with you. All right. So looking at the stock right here, look what ended up happening with SREN. It hit a resistance, it came back down. Hit a resistance, came back down. I mean, you don't need to be, and look at it, even came back even lower. Now dropped down to 670. You just need to follow the money. Joan, listen, you don't need a trading platform. You don't need NASDAQ Total View. You don't need any of this stuff right now. This is the least of your problems. You know what you need right now? Do you have $9 in your pocket? That's the only thing you need. You have $9. Everybody here have $9, can afford $9. I know it's like, of course I have $9. I mean, I wouldn't be in the trading business if I didn't have it. That's all you need right now. You don't need a platform. You don't need a brokerage firm. You don't need to talk to 10,000 people. You don't have to watch 100 videos. At the end of this presentation, all you need is $9. That's it. Everything that you see, you're going to get for $9. Now, the thing is this. NASDAQ TotalView, I do a lot of presentations with them, but as of right now, you don't need it. And the reason why you don't need it is first you have to convince yourself that you do need it. Don't be the person that you know that's obsessive and you know impulsive, you know, because that's how you lose money in trading. First, you got to know if trading is for you, because remember, I'm telling you right now, it's not for everybody. Now, the next question people always ask is they say, you know what, Fausto, how do I know these are real orders? I heard they're fake orders. You can't trust anyone. The first thing I tell everybody is this. Why would you be in business with a bunch of liars and thieves and cheaters and this and that? Like, why would you be in that business? And they're like, well, what am I supposed to do? Well, what you're supposed to do is learn how to play the game. If you knew how to play it, then you know why they did it. Listen, there are liars, cheaters, and thieves in politics. There are liars, cheaters, and thieves in the car business. There are liars, cheaters, and thieves in the in everything, construction, whatever it is. You just got to know how to play the game. That's it. If you knew what you were talking about, they couldn't lie, cheat, and steal from you. That's what it comes down to it. So let me tell you how we know between a real order and a fake order. And it all starts with tape reading, time and sales, okay? Time and sales is basically the confirmation of a transaction that took place. So when you buy and sell something, the exchange is going to post it up. Hey, you know what? Transaction went off at this price. And the colors are segregated. Green are trades that go off on the offer. Red are trades that go off on the bid. So we know exactly where they're going. Okay? We know where the transactions are taking place. Now, where's the resistance levels on WKHS? Right here. 1850, you know, 100, 2,000 shares in 30 different orders. Now, in theory, without looking at anything, we could know right away that is going to be a major resistance levels because there's a big seller out there. Now, this is the thing. Stocks break support and resistance levels all the time. And guess what? It happened with WKHS. The stock from 1 o'clock hit a resistance, came back down, hit a resistance, came back down, hit a resistance, came back down. After about 3 hours, what was that, 2 hours, whatever it is, it finally busted through it and went all the way to $21. How is that even possible? Well, when you break through a major sell order resistance level, because remember, resistance levels are made by orders, and you see the guy get executed. 1850, 2,000, 3,000, 2,000, 4,500, 1,000, 1,000, 3,000. You know, eventually people are buying it. Why would anybody buy it? Because they know they want to own it. So here you have a big block order, gets executed, and then you're wondering why these things pop the way they do. And if I saw a big order on like that get executed, what do you think is the first thing that happened? It happened to me yesterday. It happened to me yesterday. Did anybody see AMD, the stock AMD? AMD, there were orders, 100,000, 200,000, 300,000, every dollar. And then when that guy got done, and then I guess it was a short squeeze because the guy was probably doubling down every dollar higher, the thing just took off. And you're like, oh, here's the resistance. 100,000 shares, boom, the guy got executed. Then you know what? Next biggest order was a dollar higher. What did it do? Went to that next guy, took him out, went to the next order. You got to follow the money, guys. That's what it comes down to it. And the only way you know is which really sparks your interest by seeing the time and sales orders get executed. But at the end of the day, you don't got to make a killing on these stocks. See, great traders never buy at the bottom, and we never sell top. We always buy in between. So like, you know, here you have a stock like, you know, Works, WORX. You know, stock went from $2 to 14. Like, you fall off your share. You're like, my God, is that even real? I've never seen it. We do this every day. By the way, if you don't believe me, you're going to see within the next, everyone's going to join me in my trading room. But as a trader, you don't need to make $12 on a trade. Hell, if you just made 50 cents on it, on 500 shares, would it cost you $1,000? 250? Do that every single day, and there is a $50,000 salary. And some people are like, yeah, but Fausto went to 14. I don't care went to 14. I don't care if it goes to 50. Did you make money? Yeah, okay, great. Guess what? Tomorrow there'll be another one. That's all that matters. You made money, and that's it. It's not about hitting home runs. It's about hitting base hits. Because as you get better at it, you could trade more shares and you can make more money. Dow Jones goes from 29,000, almost 30,000, right back down to 18. Look where it is today. How many of you here are kicking yourself in the butt and like, damn it, why didn't I not know that? Why didn't I buy? Guess what? Stock market's not going out of business. Okay? And there's still plenty of room. Remember, the only reason why the market came down with the coronavirus, and you know what? The market was on fire, was roaring. It is no one's fault. It's no politician's fault. It's nobody's, you know, company's fault. It's all about this virus that brought the market down. And you know what? If they come out with a cure, I could tell you this. The stock market is going to explode 10 times over. And you want to know why? Because I live here in New York where all traders and some of the top CEOs of companies where I live, I one of them, my neighbor, he just bought a $1 million house across the street from me. You know what they told me? You see all this thing that's going on in New York City, what I was telling you earlier about people working from home? Do you know how much money the rent is in New York City? You know how much money people are paying for those buildings? Well, guess what? They don't need to go there anymore. We learned how to adapt. And what's going to happen, these companies are going to have more profit than anything before. Elon Musk, you heard his earnings announcements that came out regarding with Tesla. You know, he's one of the most richest people in the world right now. You know what? He didn't pay his rent in New York City. $750,000 a month rent. He didn't pay for it. He's like, you know what? I'll pay you later. All right. The thing is this. When this is all said and done, you guys are going to need to learn now, because when the market takes off, you're going to kick yourself in the butt that you didn't do it earlier. You can't learn how to trade in an hour. I could just get you excited just enough. But let's not make a mistake to get the next biggest move in the market. And the only way you're going to know that is how to play the game. Because guess what? Not every single one of them are going to move. Look at the airlines. Look at the cruise stocks. People thought they were going to pick the bottom. Where'd they go? They went down. And then we had that nice little spike. They went down. It's time to stop pretending, and it's time to start learning how to trade the right way. So this is what I want to do. I want to invite every single one of you to come and watch, not me, because I'm just a captain. I want you to look at every single money in the room and see if other people make money doing this. I want you to meet the grandmas, the grandpas, the engineers, the border control people, the veterans, the pharmacists, the doctors. I just had a beautiful letter the other day. A doctor told me he just sent his resignation letter because he's sick and tired of, you know, going and not spending time with his family. He says, you know what? I always wanted to do this. I'm making more money doing this than ever before. He said, it just wasn't the right time. I want to make sure I learn how to do this right. Guy's killing it. Killing it. One of several people that changed life. I love those stories. And guess what? You could be that story too. Like, honestly, do you really want a stimulus check? Is that really going to change your life? I'll be embarrassed right now for a stimulus check. If I was to get a stimulus check right now, if I was able to get a stimulus check, okay, that means I'm in serious problems. That means I really, really have some issues. Don't get me wrong. I wouldn't turn down free money. But at the end of the day, if I have to depend on my money, you got a serious issue. You, no matter what, you got to go make money. Why go out there and wait till they open up the economy when you could sit here and trade the market and see people every day that what you wanted to do, that you could do it yourself? So there's no better time to get into the room and see us what we're doing than today. So this is what I'm offering everybody. Remember that $9? This is what I'm asking you. Come join my trading room for 7 days. 5 days during the market hours. You got the weekends to watch these videos. And this is what you're going to get. You're going to get our cyber group room. The original live trading room that I started 25 years ago. You're seeing a bunch of them. Where do you think they learned it from? Okay. You're going to join the original room. You're going to get 3 daily market meetings, live meetings that we do in the trading room, a morning and afternoon watch list. Okay, all those stocks that we called out, if you've been watching us on Facebook or YouTube, you see, you're like, where did Fausto find those stocks? You're going to get that before they even know. You're going to be able to talk to somebody. Yes, you're actually going to be able to speak to somebody. Some people are like, I never spoke to anyone in my life. You mean that I can actually talk to someone that knows what he's talking about? Yes, because you need to make sure that, we want to make sure that you know what you get yourself involved in, because I don't want to be responsible if it's not for you. Weekly live Q&A session, 100 hours of recordings, all for $9, 3 premium workshops, and a day trading crash course. And last but not least, the best of them all is this. First 20 people register, I will actually give you a coaching class. And the only reason why we do 20 once a week, because that's the most I can handle, okay? Where do I have the time to talk to people? Well, first of all, I only work an hour a day, okay? Secondly, I'm always looking to recruit new traders so I could trade with them. And you know what? A lot of people really don't qualify to do it. So you know what? Wouldn't you like to consult a doctor before you have surgery? You know, because he might tell you, he might not, you know, tell you the truth. You know, I can make a lot of money doing surgery on you, but you have a chance of dying and you really don't need to do it. If I was a bad doctor, I would do the surgery because I need the money, right? But I'm a good doctor. Just stick what you're doing. You're doing a good job. It's not worth it. Well, that's why we do what we do. And that's why Cybertrading University has been around for so long. And that's why we've been respected. And we've been one of the most popular schools in the industry. But guess what? It's only $9. And I'll be honest with you, I don't need the $9. So at the end of the week, if you want your $9 back, you can have it. The $9, all it does is tell me if you're a real person or not. There's a lot of you here. I don't know where you came from. I don't know who you are. You know, you could be a competitor. You could be a heckler, whatever it is. So it's the only way how we kind of distinguish people that are serious and non-serious. Okay. And that's where it comes down to. So you got the link right there. Rich posted the link, or you can call up our number. I'd rather you do it online because we're, you know, you're probably, if you have to call, you can call. You can talk to one of our education advisors, but it's easy to just register online. All right. Now, does anyone have any questions? Rice, you signed up last week. Okay. So listen, if you signed up last week, listen, honestly, we are so overwhelmed, okay? Cybertrading University is having one of the best years that we ever had. Why? Because everyone wants to trade, okay? So I apologize if we haven't got to certain people yet. It is important. You probably didn't fill out your questionnaire, so we don't know who you are. We prioritize. You fill out your questionnaire that you're going to have after you fill it out. That's first important. If you don't fill it out, then obviously, you know, maybe you didn't want to fill it out, but we prioritize because the more data and information you tell us about you, the better we could help you. Okay. So make sure you fill it out, but we will get to you. Very important you fill out that questionnaire. I get this through the prize with Wealth 365. Yes, Joe. If you did it with Wealth 365, same thing. By the way, we had close to about 1,300 people in that meeting. If I could only tell you, we had more people that registered than any presenter in Wealth 365 after they saw his presentation. You know, listen, a lot of people want to learn about options. They want to learn about swing trading, Forex trading. It all starts with day trading. You got nothing to lose. Listen, instead of going out there and depending on, oh, this guy's charging you $400, $1,000, $10,000. You know what? It's probably a great deal, but why not test it out first for $9? What do you have to lose, right? All right, listen, a couple of shout outs really quick. I want to just, a couple of people just registered here. Who do we got here? Brendan. Okay, there you are. Brendan, I got you from California. Just got your registration. I see you chatting away like a madman. All right, way to go. Who else we got here that registered? Jacob, just got your registration from Chicago. Michael from Los Angeles, got you, a lot of people from California. All right. Who else we got here? Stephanie from London. All right. Got your registration. And Don S. from New England. Just got your registration. New Hampshire. Sorry about that. I see you still coming in. Any other questions? Can I post the link up here, please? Yes, the link is right there. Does everybody see it? You just posted the link. We got a couple of short ones. You go to ctu.co, not .com. trial, or you could do the other one. We just have kind of abbreviate it. Okay, any other question? Can you call me from KD? I don't know where KD is. If you could be more specific. Based on total view, do you place stop orders or just leave? No. No stop orders. That's for lazy traders. If you're not disciplined enough, then you do it. But no, when we trade, we definitely, there's a strategy behind it. Sometimes you want to expose your order and let other people know that you're out there, depending on how many shares you trade. But if you feel like you're not disciplined enough, it's the right way to go. But you never walk away from your trades, okay? South Africa, yes, absolutely. We train a lot. I have several students from South Africa in there. Yes, absolutely. And by the way, when you sign up, you don't have to start tomorrow. I mean, I recommend you start immediately, but if you want to start on Monday, start fresh and watch the videos, you could do that. I kind of recommend that. Watch the videos, watch the lesson. Because you know what it is? A lot of you are not going to understand the language, what's going on. So we have like a very detailed, and we dab it down to a science. I've been doing webinars, believe it or not, for 20 years. I've been doing it before anyone has ever even thought of doing it. Now all of a sudden, it's a big thing with the coronavirus. So we really built our whole portal page to kind of teach you in very simple, easy steps. Listen, we want to teach you enough to tell you it's not for you. Really, realistically, it's not for everybody. Everybody wants to do this, but it doesn't mean you should. Okay? Listen, a lot of people want to drive a car. Doesn't mean they should. All right? A lot of people want to be doctors. Doesn't mean they should. Do I think everybody could do it? Yes. With the right mentoring, the right education, and with the right team, you could. But you got to be mentally prepared for it. You got the opportunity right now, go out there and do it. Let me do a couple more shout outs here. Ped from, I don't even know where you're from. I'm sorry. Is that MYS? I don't know where that is. A lot of people from a lot of go, is a left. That's got to be the first of that country. I've seen a lot of them, you know, Singapore and all those. And that's someplace I couldn't even pronounce the name. It was somewhere in there. Donnie from Houston just got your registration. Welcome aboard. Who else we got here? Michael M. from Inglewood, Colorado just got your registration. Who else we got? Scott B. from Washington State. Don't mind, I'm just reading it from my phone. I don't know if you guys could see that, okay? Make it easier than looking online. Just telling you guys who I got registered. Now, guys, listen, it's very important that you fill that questionnaire because we prioritize. We need to know a little bit about you. It just makes things a little bit easier, the process easier. When you fill out and you register, there's a questionnaire. Let us know if you took training before, who your broker is, if you have level 3. So we're able to tell you what you need, what you don't need. You don't need a brokerage account. You don't need level 3. You don't need anything to be in this trading room. You just need to watch, okay? Some people don't believe that there are stocks out there that go up 300, 500%. We do it every single day. You don't believe me? You're going to see it for $9. Some people think that nobody makes money doing this. You don't believe me? You're going to see it for $9. Some people believe me that they don't show you their trades. You don't believe them? Well, believe us, you'll see them for $9. So go out there and just make the investment. You got nothing to lose. Everything to gain for $9. Some people say everybody loses money in day trading. You know what? They didn't come in my room. Okay. Now, does everybody we teach make money? Absolutely not. The only reason why traders ever fail is they got greedy and cocky. That's about it. Or they're a deer in the headlights. But how do you know that? $9. Pedro, you're from Malaysia. Okay, there you are. Sorry about that. I didn't recognize the 4-letter symbol. Kosh from Texas, Irving, Texas, just got your registration. Who else we got here that registered? Gerard G, I just got your registration, Morristown, New Jersey. All right. Who else we got here? Rodriguez from British Columbia. By the way, we teach 20% of the traders are from Canada. So if you're from Canada, I've been up to Canada for the past 15, 18 years now. So I know your market's very well. A lot of people like trading U.S. market. It's very easy to understand, so it's great. Okay, question coming over here. Sydney, Australia, Joan. I'm sorry about hard to contact at the moment. It's 3 a.m. in the morning. Oh, my God, you must be exhausted. You know what? I had a student that came from – actually, we have about 5 or 6 students from Australia, And they actually flew here for an on-site class, which is very flattering. I could imagine, you know, what it's involved. But you know what? People really want to learn how to do this. You know what? The language is very similar. At the end of the day, you got to do what you got to do. And you know what? You could probably trade the afternoon to morning. That's about it. You only need an hour. I know Australia is great because if you trade that first hour of pre-market, that's all you need. But thanks for registering, Joanne. Why don't you go take a nap? All right. All right. So I'm seeing some great questions. People are filling them out. Very important you guys let us know. If you took education from somebody, please let us know who you took it with. It helps us to know a little about your experience and how to kind of advise you if how what you've learned, you could probably still use it and maybe what you're not. So it's a very important thing that you let us know, your education. Link is not working? Really? If it's not, it should work. If it's not, Joan, call us up. I'm seeing registrations coming in. I hope we didn't crash because I'll kill the web guys. All right. We got about two more minutes left. Listen, trading, just remember, guys, you don't need to make a lot of money to do this. You don't need a lot of money to do this. And just showing what I showed you today, I only talked about, you know, what, I gave about 20, 30 minutes talking about level three. Wait till I show you this. You want to freak out? Anybody heard of this stock? Anybody heard level four before? This is going to make you, this is what's going to really show you how to trade today's markets. When I show you level four and you see something like this, you see this red bar, 220,000 shares looking to be sold. Oh, guess what? At 10 o'clock this morning, it hit it and it went back down. Never wanted to break it. Guy's still sitting there. You want to know about that? That is going to really freak you out. You thought NASDAQ level total view is going to show you? Wait till I show you level four. You know, all this good stuff is all going to be in black and white. It's all about having a game plan. Donnie, you don't have to do professional. You're not a professional. You're not a broker. It's really if you're a registered broker. So it's not, you don't have to be a professional. You're an individual. You're doing it for your own personal use. I know professionals like $80, $90, right? Yeah. Any of you are, I won't even know that. I won't say anything. what tool do you use for level four? George, did you register yet? I didn't see your name come across. Did you register? You did? Okay. So don't worry about it, George. You'll see when it comes into the trading room. Okay. No problem. Right now, I'm just here to kind of just teach you the foundation, tell you what you guys are going to get. Make sure we know who you are. And you say who you are. Get you in the trading room, see other people if they make money doing this, and then have a discussion and see if we're going to continue, if you want to continue with CTU. The $9, I always tell everyone, this is just basically an application fee. This is really what it is. You're paying an application fee. That's what it is. All right? All right, guys, same thing. I got to go to myself. I want to get ready to trade the afternoon hours. I got to get ready with my students. Thank you guys for coming. First of all, three things before we go. If you register with CTU, I look forward to teaching you. I look forward to our staff talking to you. If you found that's not for you, that's even better. Hopefully this kind of finally gave you a perspective of what's going on. But there's one person out there that I'm concerned about. If you are a professional YouTube taker and free webinar person, think you're going to take what you've learned and says, oh, I don't need to spend the $9. Let me apply it and see how it works first and then do it. Do yourself a favor. Please don't use anything we talked about. You'll do more harm than good. If you can't afford $9, you really can't afford to trade. Okay? So don't even waste your time. You need to learn from several different mentors. You want to listen to a couple of people out there. So please do yourself a favor. You got the most prestigious, greatest job in the world. Why screw it up? It takes one bad trade to blow up your account. Don't do it. It's cheaper to dish out the $9 first. All right, guys? Thank you very much. Thank you, staff, for helping everybody making this possible. And I look forward to seeing you all tomorrow morning in the live trading room. And remember, we start early, 8 a.m. before the market opens up. We do an hour and a half. We do most of our pre-market trades where we make most of our money. So make sure you're there. but you got to talk to your education advisor. So make sure you take care of that. So thanks, everybody. We're going to play a quick little video before we all go about me on NASDAQ. So let me play that video so you could see. I'm going to do one last education while you guys are registering so you can watch a video really quick of me doing a presentation on Total View on the NASDAQ Market Center, all right? So we're going to play that. So thank you very much for sticking around, and I'll see you all in class. I'll see you all tomorrow morning. Have a great day.